Hey everybody, this is Brajesh here and you are watching CABA Infoventry. In my earlier video, I shared with you some important points in check bounce case against you, that is applicability of the limitation period which you should use in the court through which you can defend yourself in the court effectively and successfully. Link for that video is given here. Now, I will share with you the another legal and important point for dismissal of check bounce case against you by the court. This is again very important point in a check bounce case, and that is legal liability which you should use in the court through which you can defend yourself in the court effectively and successfully and get the check dishonor case dismissed against you. This I am going to share with you in detail so that you can understand this properly and apply to your check bounce case in defense. Keep watching this video till end in order to get the full benefit out of this video. If your case of check bounce case falls in any of the category which I am just going to share with you, then you can defend your case effectively and the case can be dismissed by the court and you may be acquitted from check dishonor case by the court. This point is all about the legal liability. The legal liability plays a very crucial role while defending a check bounce case. Now you will ask that what is this legal liability all about? My dear friends, please check your legal liability as per section 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act when a check issued by you got bounced. Please note that every check bounce is not an offense in itself as per section 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act. Only those checks which were issued by you against the discharge of your legal liability, and if those check got bounced, then only it is an offense as per the Negotiable Instrument Act, and not that every check bounce is an offense. You may be thinking that it's imaging and you never saw your check bounce case from that angle. My dear friends, if you have issued a check against your liability, and that is your legal liability, and you have issued the check in discharge of your existing legal liability and that got bounced, then only it is an offense under the Negotiable Instrument Act and not otherwise. Meaning thereby that if you were legally liable to pay that amount to other person against your legal liability and not otherwise. If you have issued a check to repay your debt or liability, whether that is loan or liability or any other liability under a contract, and you have issued the check in discharge of that liability to other person and that check got bounced, whether you are paying your debt or liability partially by check or in full and that check has gone bounced, then that is an offense under the Negotiable Instrument Act. My dear friend, this is very technical and important point as far as defending your check dishonor case is concerned, and therefore you should understand this very carefully so that you may get the check dishonor case against you dismissed by the court on the point of legal liability itself. Now take an example wherein you have issued a check to somebody, then as per section 139 of the Negotiable Instrument Act, it is presumed under law that you have given that check to that other party in discharge of your either loan or some other legal liability and not for just fun's sake. Therefore, you have given that check in discharge of your some legal liability to that other party. This is presumed under section 139 of the Negotiable Instrument Act. it shall not be accepted by the court that you have given that check to some party or some person just for fun's sake when you were not having any legal liability or a loan on you to repay to him. Therefore, please note that the law will not accept your justification that you have given the check to that person when there was no legal liability against you. Likewise, Section 118 of the Negotiable Instrument Act presumes that whatever consideration was due against the check issued by you has already been received by you. And therefore, the check has been issued by you against already received consideration by you. The consideration means if you purchase a car from a car dealer, then you have issued the check to that car dealer for which you have already received the car from him. That you have already received means you have already got the car from that car dealer. Hence, it will be presumed that you have already received the car from that car dealer, then only you have issued that check to that car dealer. You will not issue a check in free fund to anybody, but it is issued by you against which you have already received the consideration. You have already received the consideration which you were legally entitled to receive from that person against the check issued by you. Now see, these presumptions which I have just discussed with you have to be rebutted by you to get the check bounce case dismissed in the court. These presumptions of law which I shared with you just now, you have to prove that they are not true or rebut with documentary evidence or by explaining the circumstances before the court. During the course of the trial before the court, whatever evidence or witnesses you produce before the court or whatever circumstances you explain, that should prove under what circumstances you issued the check in question to that other party or how your signed check reached in the hands of that other party. Once you throw the light on these facts or circumstances before the court by way of your statement or bayan, or by way of your witnesses or by way of your documentary evidence, then you should be able to prove before the court that whatever check you issued to the complainant, that check was not issued in discharge of your legal liability and you were not liable to pay him any amount. This should be your mission or effort to prove before the court. If you can prove this fact before the court, or if you can prove to a greater extent, even if you are not able to prove this fully, then you may be able to create a doubt in the mind of the court that whatever you are explaining before the court, those things are also possible. If you are able to prove, if not 100%, but to a greater extent before the court, that whatever you are telling or explaining before the court, that is also a possible view. In that case, various evidences produced by the complainant or the other party can also be seen with suspicion and they are also not free from doubt, then you can win the case. Now you should understand that what I have just discussed with you with the help of few examples, that what can be the difference between issuing a check by you to the other person or party or issuing a check against your legal liability to the other person or party. Now I will share with you this difference in detail. Now I will share with you this with the help of an example. For example, if a father gives a gift to his son of rupees 20 lakh by way of check and that check get bounced. Now tell me whether son can file a case against his father for recovery of that gift amount because the check get bounced. If your answer is yes, then my dear friends, you are not correct. In this case, son cannot file a case against his father for dishonor of this check because there was no legal liability of father towards his son to give a gift to him. The father was gifting this amount to his son as per his own sweet will, out of his love and affection towards his son, but he was legally not liable to give that amount as gift to his son. This is just an example. Even if you are giving any gift to any person and that check get bounced, then that person cannot file a suit against you for recovery of the gift amount. Or if you are giving a donation to somebody and that check of donation get bounced, then the person to whom you have given the donation cannot file a case against you for recovery of the donation amount if that check get bounced. If you are giving any donation to any temple like Ram Janmabhoomi or the Birla temple or Shirdi temple or to any Gurudwara like Golden temple or Gurudwara Shish Ganj or to anybody for that matter through check, then if that check got dishonored, then you are not liable to pay that amount and that person cannot file a suit against you in the court for recovery of that amount because you are legally not liable to pay that amount to them. Even if you stop the payment of a check and that check got bounced, then that person or institution to whom you have given that donation cannot file a case against you in the court for recovery of that amount due to dishonor of the check because there is no legal liability on you to pay that donation to that person or organization. Even if that person institute a case or files a case against you for recovery of that amount due to dishonor of check, then you can take a ground before the court that this amount was not your legal liability and you are not liable to pay this amount legally to that person. Hence, check bounce case shall be dismissed against you by the court because you have not purchased any goods from him or them, or you have not taken any services from them, and you have not taken any loan also from that person, and therefore this was not your legal liability to pay that amount to them. You have not given this amount as repayment of loan also, but you have given this amount to him or them as a donation or a gift, and later on you change your mind that you do not wish to give that donation or gift, and therefore this was not your legal liability. In this case, the court cannot force you to pay that amount because this was not your legal liability. Negotiable Instrument Act clearly prescribes that a check given for discharge of legal liability is only an offense under that act and not otherwise. If any other check given by you get bounced, then that is not an offense under Negotiable Instrument Act. In my next video, I will be sharing with you some more examples for your easy understanding that what is your legal liability as per Negotiable Instrument Act, so that you can win the check dishonor case against you in the court. Link for that video is given here. Stay safe and healthy. Bye-bye.